Hi everyone, this is Paris Debono of the Fortune Teller Shop. I've been a professional fortune teller since 1990. And in this video, I'm going to look at and examine and critique some of the ways fortune tellers have been portrayed in film and movies. Sometimes it's quite accurate and spot on, and other times it's kind of crazy and way off mark. So we're going to look at two movies in this video. So here is a scene in the film Before Sunrise of a palm reader.
Look at this palm reader. She's interesting looking.
Yeah.
So in this scene, this palm reader's walking around doing random palm readings for people and making money. Now, I would only do this type of reading if I was absolutely desperate and starving and living on the streets. If I was in that position, I would rather set up a little table somewhere and get people to come to me, because I would want clients or people who actually want a reading, not me going up to them and imposing on them.
Oh, no. Oh,
look
at you on your palm
reader? No.
No?
No,
no,
sure.
Hello. So these two characters do not want a palm reading. They're saying to themselves that they don't want it, which would set up the energy of it not working. So I would definitely not approach people in public.
Ich möchte deine Hand lesen. Français, Englisch? I want your palm read.
Yeah, how much is it?
For you, 50s. Okay?
Okay.
Oh, so you have been on a journey, and you are a stranger to this place. You are an adventurer, a seeker, an adventurer in your mind. You are interested in the power of the woman, in the woman's deep strength and creativity. You're becoming this woman.
So far, I'm hearing very nice words and affirmations, but I'm not seeing palmistry yet.
You need to resign yourself to the awkwardness of life. Only if you find peace within yourself will you find true connection with others. But is it stranger to you?
I guess so.
Exploded billions of years ago, they formed everything that is this world. Everything we know is stardust. So don't forget, you are stardust.
I mean, that's very nice and all.
He pretty much said it. It was very pleasant, very entertaining, but that definitely was not palm reading. She didn't look at the lines of the hands or anything about the hands that I could see in this scene. So now we're going to look at a tarot reading scene in the movie Now and Then.
The suspicious lack of details surrounding Dear Johnny's death led us to the one person we knew could help us find out more.
Your help.
I'm a little blue today, boys.
on. Give her the money. Maybe this will cheer you up. Come on in. I can't believe we're spending 10 Treehouse dollars on women.
First thing I notice about this scene is that these girls are all too young. I wouldn't want to do a reading for anyone that is younger than 18. And the second point is I wouldn't have them all sitting together either, because that would end up being a joke, or they wouldn't be taking it seriously, or they'd be giving me attitude. So even if they were 18 or over, I would probably have them sit there one at a time.
Contacted by a spirit. His name is Jonathan.
I know. I feel a strong spiritual presence here. For 10 Treehouse dollars, I'd feel it too. Silence.
So if I was doing a reading for this group and they gave me attitude like that, I would nip that in the bud straight away. I wouldn't allow that to continue. I would not start the reading until that was gone.
The spirits are here, and yes, they want to talk to you. Shuffle these twice and then cut them three times facing me. Relax your minds and bodies and be open to his presence.
Want to find out how he died.
Seven of Swords, Ten of Swords, and the Death card looks like he was murdered, probably by an enemy or someone who hated him. That would have been my response to that. So this has been a critique of fortune telling in different movies. I wanted to give a fortune teller's point of view. This is Paris Debono of the Fortune Teller Shop.